Welcome to the lesson on the area of parallelograms, triangles, and trapezoids. In this lesson, we will discuss some of the ideas behind solving these particular shapes for area. Now, these three shapes have basic formulas to find their area. However, important key features about each shape will teach us about why those formulas exist and prevent us from making mistakes when solving problems about these shapes. Now, let's take a look and recall some key features about each one of these figures. First, let's look at a parallelogram. We know that the essential features of a parallelogram are opposite and parallel sides. So the opposite sides are parallel to each other and congruent to one another. And then you're going to have a lot of individual features with the angles and diagonals as well. Let's recall a triangle, three-sided figure. Area of a triangle is derived from its height, which makes a 90-degree angle with its base. And we'll talk more about height and base a little bit later. Lastly, we get a trapezoid, usually two congruent sides and a top base, which is going to be a different size than the bottom base. So we're going to have two bases and usually two congruent sides between those two bases and angles as well. So when we start off by looking at a parallelogram, it's important to think about a parallelogram as perhaps a rectangle that has kind of been shifted over on one side. So if we think about drawing this left triangle or outlining this left triangle on this parallelogram, and if we move it to the other side, it should fit nicely on the other side of the parallelogram and essentially create a rectangle, a simple rectangle, which we know has a formula for its area of length times width. So now if I think about its length is 1, the altitude, and its width, which was 2, I get an area of 2 units squared. So in this particular case, it really was a base times height scenario, or length times width, whichever way you want to approach it. So let's take a look at some of these example problems and see which mistakes we want to make sure we don't make. I have three numbers here, and I know it's tempting to use a 5, but when it comes to base and height of a parallelogram, my height is 4, my base is 10, so 4 times 10 is 40. It is tempting to use that 5, but the 5 is simply one of the sides. In this case, I'm looking and I have sides 13 and 15. Now, 13 is not going to suffice for my height. In fact, I don't know what the height is here. What I do have is the measurement of this little outside triangle that we've created. And since I know that's 5, that green triple tells me it's 12 is the height. So 12 times 15 will then give me 180 square centimeters. As I move towards the triangle, I go back and recall some important ideas and concepts about a triangle. Now, a triangle, if divided up in two ways, can be viewed as half of a rectangle. In this case, this half of my triangle is half the rectangle, and this other half is the other one. With a right triangle, I know that my whole entire triangle makes half of its corresponding quadrilateral. And with this case, it might seem a little bit difficult to draw, but going down the altitude, I can see which portions are half of a rectangle. So from this idea, my formula is 1/2 base times height. Now, it's important to make sure that you're using the correct base and height. In particular, looking at height, we want to make sure we're always using the altitude. Now, each triangle has three altitudes, and it depends on what the base is. So if I look at this example, this triangle, altitude AD must be paired with its corresponding base, BC. If you're going to use BE, you go with AC. And if you're going to use CF, you got to go with AB. Making sure you use the correct base and height, the correct altitude, the correct corresponding base will ensure you get a correct answer. So let's solve this practice problem real quick, and we'll count units to see that we have a base of about 5 units, or exactly 5. And we're going to go ahead and calculate the altitude for this particular base. So I'm going to count 4 units in this case. So with a base and a height, I can go 1/2, 5 times 4, and I'll get an answer here of 10 square units for that triangle. Lastly, we'll take a look at a trapezoid and address some key issues regarding its formula. So I know a trapezoid has two bases. Now the bottom base, base 2, is very large, and if we imagine building a rectangle with this bottom base, it would be larger than a trapezoid. The top base, base 2, is smaller, and if I build a rectangle with that base, it would be too small for the trapezoid. So in a sense, I gotta find the middle point between these two bases, and hopefully multiplying that by the height will give me the correct area. So I add the two bases and divide it by 2, and that gives me an average of those two bases. And then of course I times this average by the height. So let's apply this. So I'm going to count the bottom base of this trapezoid, and it will be 5. I'll count the other base of this trapezoid, and in this case I get 9. And I know my height here is a simple 3, so then I plug my numbers into my formula to solve. 9 plus 5 divided by 2 times 3. 9 plus 5 is 14, divided by 2 is 7, and 7 times 3 will give me 21 square units. Now, in a more complex problem, I got to think about finding the surface area of this particular pot that might hold a plant. Now, what I do know is that the very bottom of this structure is a square, so 8 times 8 is going to give me 64, and I'll keep that bottom off to the side for now. Now, let's go ahead and solve one of these trapezoids, and knowing that I have 4, I can times by 4 later. So 8 plus 11 for my two bases divided by 2 times a height of 10. 8 plus 11 will give me 19 divided by 2, gives me 9.5 times 10 for the height, and I get 95 for one trapezoid. Since I have 4, I'll multiply this by 4. 95 times 4 will give me 380, and I can't forget to go ahead and add that bottom square base of 64, and my final answer here is 444 square units.